Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Tenorshare. The official release of iOS 17.3 just launched, and I'm sure many of you have already made the jump to the latest system. Alongside the excitement for new features, some users have reported encountering bugs and issues, such as battery draining. If you're among those facing challenges, you might want to return to the stability of iOS 17 or earlier. Here is a note. The ability to downgrade iOS on different iPhone models depends on Apple's support for specific firmware versions. Once Apple closes the signing window for a particular version, like iOS 17.1, downgrading becomes impossible. Fortunately, there's a viable solution that allows you to revert to iOS 17.2 for your iPhone 11 or later, and iOS 16.5 for iPhone X or earlier while retaining your valuable data. Here I will downgrade to iOS 17.2, for example. Curious about the downgrade process? Let's delve into the steps. Step 1, turn off. Find my iPhone. Begin by navigating to Settings, tap on your profile, and select Find My. Ensure that Find My iPhone is turned off. Step 2, create a backup. Connect your phone to the computer. Open iTunes and go to the summary page. Click on Backup to create a local backup. Make sure your storage has ample space for the backup. Then wait for it to finish. Now let's head to the downgrade process. Step 3, downgrade iOS 17.3. Here is a thing, if you want to downgrade with iTunes, it may have to go through a lot of steps. For your convenience, I will now show you a simpler way first, which is to use ReiBoot for 3 steps and then show you how to downgrade with iTunes. ReiBoot provides a reliable alternative. ReiBoot's downgrade feature is way more helpful than iTunes. It's super easy, automatically figures out your iPhone model and the right version to downgrade to, hardly ever messes up, and its internet connection works out fine. Let's move on. Method 1, downgrade with ReiBoot. Connect your device. Open ReiBoot. Click the downgrade button. Select downgrade. It auto detects the downgrade version. No need for manual firmware downloads, and the process is practically error-free. When it's done, initiate the downgrade process. Then wait for it to finish. And there you have it. If you want to know how to downgrade with iTunes, let's move on. Method 2, downgrade with iTunes. While the backup is underway, visit the ipsw.me website to locate the iOS 16 file for your iPhone model. Download the file and wait for the process to complete. Then, downgrade with iTunes. Return to iTunes. Hold the Shift key, click on Restore iPhone, and select the ipsw file. And your iPhone will downgrade from iOS 17.3 to iOS 17.2. iTunes may prompt you with an error or no support for iOS 17.3. You can always go back to explore the alternative method with ReiBoot. Step 4, restore from backup. Regardless of the method used, a reset is necessary. You can restore the earlier backup from the activation process by iCloud or restore by iTunes. Before doing so, make a slight adjustment to the backup for compatibility with iOS 17. Follow the steps to modify the backup. To do this, hold down the Win and R keys to open the Run dialog box. Type in %appdata% and hit Enter. Navigate to Apple Computer, Mobile Sync, and open the backup folder. The backup we created should be the most recent one, based on the last modified time. Inside the folder, scroll down to the bottom and find the info. open it in Notepad. Press Ctrl plus F to open the search bar and search for the word product. Not too far down, you'll see the product version. Below that, it should say iOS 17.3. Change that to iOS 17.2 and save the file. Now we can go back to iTunes and start the restore process. Click on Restore Backup and select the backup we just modified. iTunes will start the restore process and your iPhone will restart. You can set up your phone again. This time, all your apps, photos, and other data will be restored. And there you have it. Thanks for watching. For more insightful tips, subscribe to the Tenorshare channel or explore another video to continue learning. Until next time.